In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create a video graphic, which is a graph combined with a video clip that relates to the data shown in the graph. For example, this video graphic shows the change in sea level recorded by a tide gauge and plotted in a line graph that was then superimposed on a time-lapse film of waves lapping on a beach. The idea is to create a visually interesting and memorable graphic that can then be used on a website, in a tweet, or as supplementary online material for a journal article. All you need is Photoshop and iMovie to recreate this example of a video graphic. Let's begin in Photoshop, which we need to make the background of the graph transparent. I'm using Photoshop CS6. If you're using a different version of Photoshop or some other program, the process of making the background transparent may differ, and you may need to read up on that. So let's open the graph image, which, as you see, has a white background. Now, all I need to do is select the magic wand tool here, and then tap anywhere in the white portion of the image. That selects all contiguous white portions of the image. Hit delete, and the white background disappears. This checkered background that you see is just there to indicate where the image is transparent. It won't be visible when we save the image. Now, you may have to do some cleanup of the text to remove the white background from inside some letters and numbers. Once you've got all the background removed, save your image to another file name to preserve the original. You want to save the file as a PNG, which stands for Portable Network Graphic. This will preserve the transparency. If we open that image, we'll see the graph now with a grayish background. However, it's going to be transparent when we superimpose it. You can use any movie editing program to complete the next step. I'm going to be using iMovie. So here you see a few video clips. I'm going to use a 10-second segment of this time-lapse clip of the ocean. I select the segment by dragging until I have the 10 seconds. Then I tap the plus sign, which drops the selected clip into the timeline. Now I've got to import the graph. To do this, I tap the down arrow and find the image in my files. Now the image appears in my iMovie event library. The thumbnail is on a black background, so it's hard to see the full graph. But when I pull it into the timeline and place it on top of the video clip, you can see the graph is there and its background is transparent. Now we just have to make a few adjustments. First, we change the role of that image from a cutaway to a picture-in-picture. We also need to change from a Ken Burns effect to fit, which fits the entire graph into the frame. Now all I have to do is reposition and resize the graph. Now, when the clip plays, we see the graph superimposed on the video of the ocean waves. Once we're satisfied with how it looks, the final step is to save it to file. Now we have a 10-second video graphic for a website or some other use. You can also add music or a voiceover in iMovie to explain the graph. For more information about making videos like this, check out my ebook, The Scientist Videographer, available at iTunes, Amazon, and Smashwords.